In this video, I want to talk about the Line 6 Helix moving into 2021. Why is it still a great investment? Why is it still a great tool for people to use? And should you be concerned about it becoming outdated or having the successor come out in a few years? I don't think that's going to happen. I think we have at least 7, 8, maybe 10 years with the Helix. It's a tool meant to be used in the moment, and really when you buy any digital product, you should expect that the value of it depreciates over the next couple years. Digital gear becomes irrelevant quickly. However, the Line 6 Helix is always getting new updates, and Line 6 has been putting a ton of money into the development and support of this product. I think we have a lot of years left with it. I'm a huge fan of my tube amps and my analog pedals. I've not gotten rid of those, but I have owned the HX Stomp for the last 2 years, and I've been really happy with it. I have no incentive to try and sell you it. I'm not affiliated with Line 6, but I just want to share my own experience and why this is a very practical thing to own in 2021. So the first reason, the biggest one I think, in my opinion, is just that guitar modeling is the future, whether you like it or not. It's reliable, it's consistent, it's adaptable to any situation, and whether you're a hobbyist or a professional, I think that the Line 6 Helix especially is going to serve you well. So let's talk about the reason why I had purchased the HX Stomp in the first place. It wasn't because I was looking forward to getting into modeling. I think I was kind of regretting it, even though I knew it was something that I needed to do eventually. I had been working on cruise ships for years. I started in 2017, and in most cases, there was always a backline amp ready for me on the ship, and I would show up with a single guitar and a medium-sized pedal board, something that I can travel easily with, and then it would be reliable and I would use for the couple-month contract. I had worked with Royal Caribbean and Princess Cruises in the past, and they always had an amp on backline for me. However, this new gig coming up on the Cunard Queen Mary 2, they insisted that I go direct. It's a way to keep the stage volume down. It keeps the mix a little bit cleaner. It's easier. It's one less thing to have to move around. Sometimes the band is moving on stage as a prop kind of, but anyway, I had to go direct, so I needed a way to cover amp and cabinet simulation. The HX Stomp was a way for me not to ditch my entire pedal rig that I had grown to love, but just kind of incorporate something that could be versatile and fit a lot of different situations. Sometimes I would play with a live amp and I had presets for that. Sometimes I needed the amp and cabinet simulation on the Helix. Sometimes I would run into the effects return of an amp and I would bypass the preamp in that amp. I would use the amp simulation from the Helix, however not the cabinet simulation, because obviously it's coming from the amp that I'm heading into. But there's just a whole lot of different ways to use guitar modeling. And more recently, it's really great to have a modeler on your rig, whether that's your full rig or not, just because it's very easy to replace if something goes wrong. Number one, it's nice to know that if a cable or anything else on my rig goes bad, I can always just pull the HX Stomp off and use any of the number of all-in-one presets that I've made. So you can use this thing as an all-in-one rig where you don't need any other pedals. It's a great way to have a backup with you at all times. If I have a problem with the HX Stomp itself, it's nice to know that Line 6 is sold all over the world. Even working on cruise ships, I can probably head out, find a music store, purchase a new unit. Now, I haven't actually had any problems with mine, and Line 6 has great customer service if you're ever in the need for a replacement unit. But it's nice to know that I had the ability to go out, buy a replacement in whatever weird country I might be in, come back to the ship, and I could load on all my presets from my computer, and that whole process might only take 15 minutes. So just by owning the Line 6 Helix, I feel like you have a backup rig with you at all times if you need it. So the question you might be asking yourself is, how the heck do you make the decision between all the different options out there? The Neural DSP stuff is brand new. Fractal has been relied upon for years, and a lot of people are just really into it because that's what they've been using forever. The Boss stuff is pretty affordable and great to use. The Line 6 Helix stuff, for myself, the reason I chose to use it, and this is big reason number two to get a Helix in 2021, is just that it's really user-friendly. The interface is incredibly approachable. It's not difficult to use at all. I'm not a very technical-minded person myself. I'm not great with computers and menu diving on pedals. I tend to get overwhelmed easily, but the Helix was very easy to use. You can edit your presets on the actual device. There's a lot of knobs and menus you're gonna have to go through. However, plugging it in via USB to your computer, it'll open up on a desktop app, which is incredibly simple. I honestly think anyone can do it. Going into reason number three, I had just mentioned that the Helix has a USB capability to connect to your computer. You can use that to edit the presets, but you can also use any of the Helix products to act as an interface. So if you don't have an interface already, you can use this as an interface. If you have a slow computer, it's actually really great to be able to use the Helix because you monitor directly from it. So you can set the buffer size in your DAW as high as you need. You're not going to hear any delay because you monitor directly from the headphone output. So using the Helix is just incredibly simple to do. and for a lot of other reasons, it's a smart thing to do because we actually have the ability to take a direct out from the Helix in addition to the affected signal that you're getting. So in your DAW, if you load up inputs 1 and 2 from the Helix, that'll be your affected tone. That'll be essentially exactly what's coming out of the left and right outputs. If you decide to load in and on a separate track, make the inputs input 5 and 6, that'll be a direct tone. So whatever's heading into the input of the Helix, that'll be what's recorded. This is very useful if you decide later on down the road that you want to reamp it, you want a different kind of sound, you can do that. Now, reason number 4 to get a Helix is that we also get the huge discount on Helix Native. So this is a plugin for your DAW. If you're making recordings, using Helix Native is a great way to take that DI track that you had just done, that you just recorded, and reamp it. If you want to manipulate the sound that you were getting, maybe you want a different amp tone, or you want to take off the reverb that you had gotten earlier, you just create the preset that you're using. You can drag it from your unit onto the desktop, from the desktop into your DAW. It's very simple. And then just take off the effect that you were using that you decided you didn't like. So ordinarily, Helix Native is $500, I believe, $400 or $500. With the discount, if you own a Helix product, it comes down to $100, and if you're patient and wait for a sale, it'll drop to $70. So Helix Native, it's just incredibly useful, and you also get a ton of plugins, different sounds that you can use on your full band mixes. I've used some of the modulation plugins on keyboard parts. It works really well for a lot of stuff. Now, I could go on forever talking about all the possibilities of plugins and other small reasons why Helix is a great thing to own, but my fifth and final reason that you might consider purchasing a Helix in 2021 is that Line 6 is constantly putting out free updates to make it even better than it's already been. It's been out for about 4 years now, and in that time we've had a ton of updates. In 2020 we had two major ones. Update 2.9 brought a lot of new amps and cabinets that people had been requesting, that they were hoping would be added to the Helix. There actually is a forum where you can request new features be added to the Helix. I'll link that down below. Line 6 reads that, they respond to it, and when they put out new updates, they often actually put in what people are asking, which is a pretty cool thing to do. So update 2.9 came in like April or May-ish of this year. Update 3.0 came a few months later. They added even more amps and cabs and a ton of new polyphonic effects, which I know was that took a lot of research and time to figure that out from the development team. My point is that Line 6 is making their units better and better at no additional cost to the customer. That's a pretty cool thing to do as a company as far as I'm concerned. And lastly, one more bonus reason to maybe consider a Line 6 Helix. If you're on the fence about whether or not you're going to work well with a modeler, or if you're going to run into issues on down the line, it's notorious that Line 6, Yamaha in general, but Line 6 has fantastic customer service. If you ever run into an issue, they'll be there to assist you. I haven't really had any issues with my HX Stomp, but I've read plenty of people who said they might, like for example, the old LTs, when they had just come out, they had a faulty volume pedal. Line 6 replaces that to everyone at no cost, whether you're the original owner or not. So there it is, my 5 top reasons to consider purchasing a Line 6 Helix unit in 2021. If you enjoyed this video, hit the subscribe button. There's a lot of Helix content on this channel, free stuff, preset walkthroughs, and playing samples and stuff that I think you'll enjoy. Hit the like button so someone else is likely to see this video and hopefully join our awesome community. Like I said, I have no official affiliation with Line 6. I do have my own preset library, so if you've just gotten the Helix or are considering getting the Helix and you'd like to jumpstart your own preset collection, I'll have a link to my own preset library down in the description. It's a folder of 50 plus presets that I'm constantly updating. Updates are always free, so whenever I add new amps or stuff that's a result of the new Helix updates, I throw them in that folder, and everyone that has purchased it over the last couple of years has access to that. Thanks for checking out the video. I hope it was helpful. Take care. I hope to see you in another one.